to unfold the flag.
That's what it is.
Cool. Flag salute.
Very good morning.
morning to everyone. I wish a happy Independence Day to one and all gathered here. So we all know that we are celebrating 78th anniversary of Independence Day, and one cannot forget the struggles of our past freedom fighters behind getting independence. This is a past history, quite inspiring and a proud moment for any Indian born on this blessed land. So I would like to quote the wonderful words said by Swami Vivekananda: "The future of India is in the hands of its youth." Thought-provoking words, right? So the India tomorrow is being shaped by the dreams and its efforts of its citizens today. So what do you think are the qualities that one should develop to look towards the future? Firstly, staying updated in current events, participating in discussions, and exercising our right to vote is the foremost thing that one should do as a citizen of India. The youth must develop critical thinking so that we can analyze information and make wise decisions. Success, growth, and development cannot be achieved by mere knowledge. Knowledge that is not being transferred is futile. So by being respectful and responsible, one can gain ownership of their actions. And also one should always be understanding the global issues and also appreciate different cultures. Bhagat Singh has once said, "It is easy to kill individuals, but not the ideas." Very true indeed. So one should learn from their failures and should not give up challenges. Continuously seek knowledge, develop new skills, and make new innovations that will shape our future, our nation, and the world. So let's pledge to build a nation that becomes a shining example that can be achieved only through continuous hard work and dedication. Jai Hind.
Yuva Krishna of class 7.
வணக்கம். அனைவருக்கும் என் இனிய சுதந்திர தின நல்வாழ்த்துக்கள். சுதந்திர தின காலங்கள். காந்தியின் கால் தோன்றது, பாரதியின் விரல் தோன்றது, தூக்கிட்டு தூக்கிட்டு கயர்கள் தோன்றது, ஓரோ சுட்டு ஊழல் தோன்றது, தேங்கு தேங்கு ஆம்பியும் தோன்றது, பல பிராதிகள் மீனர்களின் உயிர்கள் தோன்று தேங்கு பெற்ற சுதந்திரம் நம் சுதந்திரம். போற்றுவோம் தினம் தினம் அவ்வாறு பாடு பெற்று பெற்று சுதந்திர தினத்தன்று தேசிய கொடியை நின்று சுமத்தி அனைவரும் சொல்வோம் வந்தே மாதரம். பல சுதந்திர போராட்ட தியாக சுடர்களுக்கு அனைவரும் செலுத்துவோம் வீர வணக்கம். இந்திய நின்று பெருமிதம் கொள்கிறோம், சுதந்திர தினத்தை போற்றுவோம். நன்றி.
Special song by students of class 5, 7, and 8.
வந்தனம் வந்தனம் கிருஷ்ணாடே வந்தனம் பாரதம்.
class 6 are here to share the information about unknown Indian freedom fighters.
Good morning to one and all present here. I am going to tell about Anura Asaf Ali. Anura Asaf Ali was an unsung gem who battled for freedom. She was born on July 16, 1909 in Uttar Pradesh. She was a fearless and courageous Indian educator, political activist and publisher. In 1929, she married Asaf Ali, a political leader who inspired her to follow his footsteps. She was an active participant in the Indian independence movement. Her initial movement began during the Salt Satyagraha. She participated in various protests against the British rule. He is best known for hoisting the Indian flag in Bombay during the Quit India movement in 1942. She is popularly known as the Grand Old Lady of Independence. She died on 29 July 1996. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Happy Independence Day for everyone. Today I am going to tell about Bhagat Singh. Bhagat Singh was a great freedom fighter of India. He born on 28 September 1907 in Panga village, Lionpur district of Punjab. His father's name was Sardar Kishan Singh. His mother's name was Vidyavati Kaur. He devoted his life to the freedom movement at the age of 13 years. He founded the Navjawan Bharat Sabha in 1926. He held the title of Shahid-e-Azam for his sacrifice at a young age. Thank you.
Good morning everyone. I am Sahil. Today I am going to tell a few lines about Lokmanya Tilak. Lokmanya Tilak is a great leader of India in freedom struggle. He was also known as Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Bal Gangadhar Tilak was born on 23 July 1856 in Ratnagiri, Maharashtra. His father name was Gangadhar and his mother name was Parvati Bai. The famous slogan "Swaraj is my birthright and I shall have it" is given by Lokmanya Tilak. Lokmanya Tilak started newspapers like Kesari and Maratha. Such a great leader passed away at 1st August 1920. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Begum Sayed Maha was a key singer in India Rebellion of 1857. She was the wife of Nawab Waji Ali Shah, the last of Nawab Adwa. She played a crucial role in the siege of Lucknow and mobilized troops to fight against the British. Despite facing defeat, she continued to fight against the British, eventually went to exile in Nepal where she died in 1879. She is remembered as a symbol of India, resistance against the British colonial rule and founding female figure in India's struggle for independence. She was born in Jam of Masjid Kampur in Kathmandu. Her grave has become a place of remembrance for who admire her courage and contribution to Indian struggle for independence. Begum Hazrat Maha was spoken by Hara Mahadev Anurahala.
Good morning to one of our present here. Today I am going to tell about Kumaraswamy Kamarajar. Kamarajar was born on 15 July 1903. He was a man of honor, dignity, integrity and courage. He lived a simple life. Even when he became one of the most powerful politicians in the national politics, he chose to live in simplicity. He grew up in a small village in Tamil Nadu and went ahead to become the national president of the Congress Party and kingmaker of the Indian politics. As the chief minister of Tamil Nadu, he opened nearly 6,000 schools and introduced midday meal scheme to encourage the students to attend the school, and he died on 2nd October 1975. Now I am going to tell a slogan that Kamarajar quoted in English.
The future of India depends on how you educate the children. Success does not come by itself. You have to strive hard for it. Do not give a fish to a man. Instead, teach him how to fish. Thank you.
Good morning. I am going to tell about Peer Ali Khan. Peer Ali Khan was born in 1812 at Patna, Bihar. He was a bookseller. Ali Khan played a leading role in the organization of the Great Revolt of 1857 in the district of Jhola, 1857. He was captured by the British after the defeat of rebel forces. Thank you.
Good morning, one and all present here. Today I am going to tell about Prati Lata Vadhe. Prati Lata Vadhe was born on 5th May 1911 and she was died on 1932, and she is a great leader, felt that Hinduism was towards women and wrote the book of Miserable Love Lies. And she wrote the upper caste of Hinduism were women. She founded a widow's home at Pune and provided a shelter and to widows who had been treated badly by their husbands and relatives. Here women were trained so that they could be support themselves economically. Felt that Hindu women were adopting Western ways and values. Muslims were also worried about them in past of the change. As you can see, by the end of 19th century, for reformer, they wrote the book Edit magazine, founded a school and set up as an association. Thank you. And once again, happy Independence Day. Jai Hind.
Good morning. My name is Varna. Today I am going to tell about Katta Singh Saraba. Katta Singh Saraba was born on May 24, 1896 in Ludhiana district in Punjab, India, and died on November 16, 1915 at the age of 19 by execution through hanging. His mother's name was Sahib Kaur and his father's name was Sardar Mangal Singh Sandhu. His full name was Sahib Katta Singh Saraba and his real name was Kishan Singh Saraba. He was 15 years old when he joined the Gaddar Party. His famous quotation was, "I will get the freedom or I will get the death." Katta Singh Saraba was an inspiration to Bhagat Singh. Bhagat Singh's famous quotation, "They may kill me, but they cannot kill my ideas," was inspired by Katta Singh Saraba. Thank you. Happy Independence Day.
Good morning. Today I am going to tell about Lal Bahadur Shastri. Lal Bahadur Shastri was born on 2nd October 1904 in Mughal Sarai, Uttar Pradesh of India. He was our second Prime Minister of India. Each year we celebrate 2nd October as Lal Bahadur Shastri Jayanti. Marking his birth anniversary, he was not only a prominent political leader, but also a famous freedom fighter who coined the famous slogan, "Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan." Shastri's leadership was held instrumentally in the year 1965, Indian-Pakistan War, the Triassamite Agreement and Green Revolution. Thank you. I wish you all of you a very happy Independence Day.
Good morning. I am going to tell about Tirupur Kumaran. Tirupur Kumaran, also known as Tirupur Kumaran, was a significant figure in Indian independence movement. Born to Kumaraswamy Mudalayar on 4th October 1904 in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. He founded the
Desabandhu Youth Association to promote the ideas of independence and nationalism among the youth. Kumaran became a symbol of resistance when he participated in a protest march during which he Patel injured by police lathi charge. Despite his injuries, he held on the Indian flag until his death, earning the name Kodikatta Kumaran, who sacrificed his life to protect the flag. Thank you.
Good morning, Wonderland present here. My name is Vikrati. Today I am telling about Rani Chennamma. Kittur Rani Chennamma is known as a Queen of Kittur. She was a general Indian freedom fighter who plays an important role in struggle against British colony rule. Her people, she also became a presidency against the British Raj. Thank you. I wish you happy Independence Day.
Good morning. My name is A. Sudiksha Reddy from 6A. Now I'm going to tell you about Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was born on October 31, 1875 in Nandivar, Gujarat in India. And he was died on December 15, 1950 in Bombay, now Mumbai. Was an Indian barrister and a statesman, one of the leaders of the Indian National Congress during the struggle of Indian independence. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel is also known as Iron Man of India. He is remembered as a very strong and dynamic freedom fighter of India. He played a crucial role in bringing the people of the country together to fight for the independence of the nation. Now I am going to tell you about Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel in a small poem. Hey to the Sardar Patel, hey to the tea, O steel wool, remembering the tea, the nation is
1907 in May 15th. He is the member of Hindustan Socialist Association. He died on 1931, March 23rd. Shahid Divas is celebrated on 23rd March. I is observed in this memory.
Good morning, one and all present here. I am tell about Rani Lakshmibai. Rani Lakshmibai was a great freedom fighter of India. She is popularly known as Jhansi Ki Rani. She was born on 19th November 1828 at Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh. Rani Lakshmibai fought very bravely with the British to save Jhansi. While fighting near Gwalior, she was badly injured. She did not surrender to the British and died heroically. Rani Lakshmibai died on the battlefield in 1858. Thank you. Take
it. No, because freedom fighters have sacrificed their life for freedom without showing them to the world. So we show our gratitude to them by saying a powerful mantra all of together. Come on, friends. Vande Mataram. Vande Mataram. Vande Mataram. Jai Hind.
Thank you.
Speech in Hindi by Adushi of Class 7.
नमस्कार, आज मैं आपको एक कविता सुनाने जा रही हूँ जो एक महान कवि ने लिखी थी। क्या देखा है रातों रात पेड़ का जल जाना, क्या देखा है वो मंजर बच्चों का भूख से मर जाना, कहने को धरती अपनी हुई थी पर भोजन का न एक निवाला था, धूप तो उगता था हर दिन पर हर घर में अंधियारा था, बैसाखी का पर्व मनाने घर घर से दीपक निकले थे, घर को नोच न पाए जो देश बचाने निकले थे, जलिया बाग हत्याकांड कहलाया जिसमें बच्चे बूढ़े सब मर गए थे, निर्दोषियों का की दोनों पड़े कुर्बानी, क्या कसूर था उस बेबस माँ का जिससे रोटी उसकी किलकारी थी, धीरे धीरे आक्रोश बढ़ा सबके सर पे क्रोध चढ़ा, गांधी जी ने असहयोग आंदोलन चलवाया तो हमने भी चोरी चोरा कांड कराया, बेबस समझते थे इसलिए हम पर हुकूमत करते थे, पर देश पर जान कुर्बान करने से हम भारतवासी डरते थे, बहुत शानी अब तो देश को पाए जो हथियार अपनाना था, गांधी जी ने धीरज धरा और कहा कि अहिंसा को ही अपनाना है, जो पत्थर नहीं है सभी अंग्रेजों को सिखाना है, हिंसा को हथियार बनाया और फिर हमने अंग्रेजों को अपने देश से भगाया, और इस तारीख को हमने सुनहरे अक्षरों से गढ़वाया, नहीं हमारा स्वतंत्रता दिवस है भाइयों जो शान से 15 अगस्त कहलाया, 15 अगस्त
से आगे बढ़ रहे हैं, हमारे देश के युवा में देश को बदलने की ताकत है, भविष्य युवा पीढ़ी पर टिका है, इसलिए यह हमारा फंसा है कि हम देश की सेवा करें और अपने देश को बेहतर बनाने के लिए हर संभव प्रयास करें, जय हिंद जय भारत। శుభోదయం. ముందుగా మీ అందరికీ 78వ స్వాతంత్ర దినోత్సవ శుభాకాంక్షలు. తెల్లదొరల నుండి స్వాతంత్రాన్ని తీసుకురావడానికి కృషి చేసిన ఎందరో వీరులందరికీ మన హృదయపూర్వక అంజలి ఘటిస్తూ, బ్రిటిష్ పాలన నుండి స్వాతంత్రాన్ని సంపాదించి 77 సంవత్సరాలు కావస్తున్న పేద దళిత కుల మత ప్రాంత విభేదాలు చూపకుండా ఆనాడు ఉపనిషత్తులు వేదాంగాలు భారత రామాయణాలు భాగవతాలు భగవద్గీత గ్రంథాలు భారతామణిలో వర్ధిల్లుచూ అహింస కృత దయ సత్యాలను గురించి ప్రపంచానికి తెలియజేసిన ఆదర్శ భూమి పవిత్ర భూమి మన భారత భూమి. అంత గొప్ప పవిత్ర భూమిలో ఈనాడు కుల మత ప్రాంత విభేదాలు రోజు రోజుకు మానవతా విలువలు అణగంటుతున్న సమయంలో భరత జాతి ఖ్యాతిని అంబరానికి నింపే యువశక్తి యువత నేటి బాలలే రేపటి భావి భారత పౌరులు, దేశ ఖ్యాతిని అభ్యున్నతని కీర్తిని నిలబెట్టాల్సిన బాధ్యత విద్యార్థులమైన మనలో ప్రతి ఒక్కరిలో ఈ భావన అవినీతిని భారదోలే గొప్ప శక్తిగా మారి జనని జన్మభూమిష్య అని మొక్కై వందనిదే మానై వంపున అనే నానుడితో పంచభూతాలకు లేని కుల మత భేదం మానవ జాతికి ఎందుకో, ఇలాంటి అవినీతి జాతీయాన్ని అంతమొందించడానికి గొప్ప శక్తిగా తయారై మనమందరం ఎందరో త్యాగమూర్తులు చేసిన పోరాటాన్ని స్వాతంత్రాన్ని కాపాడడంలో యువశక్తిగా మారి నవ్య కవిత్వానికి నాంది పలికిన గురుజాడ వారి అడుగు జాడల్లో స్వామి వివేకానంద వారి స్ఫూర్తి ఆశయాలతో వారి గౌరవాన్ని నిలిపి స్వాతంత్రోద్యమానికి కృషి చేసిన త్యాగమూర్తులను స్మరించుకొని వారి ఆశయాలను సాధిద్దాం. జై హింద్. మరొక్కసారి మీ అందరికీ స్వాతంత్ర దినోత్సవ శుభాకాంక్షలు.
That's my students of 7th and 8th.
कदाचित शामी आने के तक दीवारे नीले आसमाने के तक आजा जिंदे शामी आने के तक आजा जल्दी वाले नीले आसमाने के तक
Class 5 and 6.